Today, we're going to see that how ChatGPT can help us in writing Excel functions. We're going to begin with simple examples and then move on to more complex ones. Let's move towards our tutorial. This is Mir Salan and you're watching Growth Mindset. For using ChatGPT, we are going to type chat.openai.com and we are going to land on homepage where we have option of login or sign up. If you already have an account, we are going to log in by clicking on this, and if you want to sign up, so we can sign up from here. Once we land on the homepage, after signing in, we have two options over here, GPT 3.5 and GPT 4. GPT 3.5 is a free version and GPT 4 is a paid version. So for now we will be using the free version. Here we are going to see that how the ChatGPT can help us in various examples. In this example, I have a data set that contain the item wise revenues. I want to calculate the total revenue over here, and I being a beginner, I don't know how the Excel works. So for that, we are going to use ChatGPT and see how it can help us here. Now for finding the sum, I have written, as an Excel expert, tell me that I have a data in my Excel sheet starting from cell reference B4 to B12 and I want the sum of it. Let's see what answer it generates. Now it has given me a detailed explanation, and here it says type the following formula. I'm going to copy the code from here, go back to my Excel sheet, and I will just press Ctrl V to paste it, and here I can see that it has simply given me the summation of all of this column. Now moving on to our next example. Here in the second example, I can see that I have the profit and loss statement, but it is all jumbled up. All of these highlighted rows are the subtotals, and as a non-finance professional, I want to find the net profit using the non-colored rows. So how can I do that? Let's move to ChatGPT and see how it can help me out. Here I have written, I want to calculate net profit in Excel worksheet. Revenue is in cell B5, expenses are in cell B7, B8, B10 and B11. So let's see what it responds. Let me copy the code from here and see how it works. Here I press Ctrl V, and if I press F2, and I can see that it has taken revenue in the first place and then subtracted the cost of goods sold, admin, financial expenses and corporate taxes. So it has calculated the net profit for me. I being a non-finance professional have got the answer that I wanted. Now we are going to move towards a little bit complexer examples after we have seen that how the ChatGPT works. Now in this example, we will be seeing that how we can fetch the quantity sold on the basis of the lookup value that is in cell D4 from the table that is over here. Then we're going to see that how ChatGPT can assist us in alternate formulas as well. So here I have a data set with cell reference range of A4 to B12, and I want to pick values from second column of my data set on the basis of lookup value in cell D4 using VLOOKUP. Suggest me a formula how to do it. Now let's see how it responds. It has given me a formula over here. I just copy the code and here I paste it. Now we can see that ice cream shake is 37,913, and here also it's same. So if we go in this drop down and if we change for any other option, snow cream, and here we can see 56,628. But what if we want to use some other formula? So we can ask the ChatGPT for it. Now I have written, suggest me an alternate formula to this. One thing to notice over here is that it will be acting as if you are chatting with some person, because I'm not giving any context of what I want, but it is picking up the previous chat and it is making the sense out of it. I click over here to send a message, and now it is generating the response. And here I can see that it has suggested me as an alternate to VLOOKUP formula to use is an index and match combination. And it defines all of the things. I just copy the code, go once again in my Excel sheet, press Ctrl V to paste it, and here again I can see, if I press F2, and I can see that it has applied the formula perfectly. So again, if I change it to some other value, so it is changing dynamically. But what if I'm not satisfied with either the VLOOKUP, index and match, and I want my results from XLOOKUP? So let's see how ChatGPT can help us in that. Now, without giving any previous context, I have written how can I apply the same formula using XLOOKUP. So the ChatGPT understands what I'm talking about. Let's see its response. It's generating the response, and here I copy the code, and here I will press Ctrl V, and I can see that I get the same results. So if I'm going to change it, all of these are giving me same results on the basis of the lookup value that is over here, strawberry ice cream. It is picking in the data of quantity sold from this column with the lookup value being this value. Let's move towards our next example. Now in this example, I want the calculation of annual revenues, and that on the basis of multiplication within each row of column B and column C. I don't want to create another column D to calculate that. And then from there on, once all of the values in each rows have been multiplied, I want the sum of that. So let's ask ChatGPT that how it can assist me in doing that. Here I write that write me a formula for the data set starting from cell B4 to C12 in Excel sheet, where I want multiplication of both columns in each row and then sum it. So it has started generating an answer for me. Well, here it suggests a sum product. I just copy the code, press Ctrl V over here. If I click on F2, we can see that it has used the sum product for both of the columns and it has given us the total revenue. But what if I want the answer around it to nearest 10? How we can do that? Once again, we move towards ChatGPT, and here I ask further round it to nearest 10. It has given me this code. I copy it, go back in my Excel workbook, paste it over here, and here we can see that it has used the function of mRound, then sum product, and this is how it has given me an answer which is rounded to nearest 10. Further, in our next example, I want to count all the cells containing text cream. Here I can see that it has no cream over here, vanilla ice cream, and then strawberry ice cream. So there are many different type of ice creams which have the cream word used in it. So I want to count all of these cells. Let's see how ChatGPT can help me in this. Now I ask ChatGPT that in my Excel dataset in column A, write me a formula to count all the cells containing text cream. I send the message, and here it has written me a counter formula. So let's copy the code, and here I paste it by pressing Ctrl V, and it says that out of 1515 rows, 840 contain the text cream in column A. Let's make our example a little bit more complexer. Now I want to see that I want to sum the quantities of product containing text cream and sold over 20,000 units. Once in ChatGPT, I write in my Excel worksheet sum all the quantity sold for cream which is greater than 20,000 units sold. Where cream is in column A and quantity sold in column B, cream in column A is a partial match. So I'm telling that this is not a complete match, it is a partial match. Wherever you find the word cream, you need to pick the data from there and sum it if the quantity sold is above 20,000 units. Now it has suggested me a formula of SUMIFS, so I just copy the code and paste it over here. And now it is giving me the sum of the quantities of the product containing the text cream and sold over 20,000 units. Now we saw that we began with a very simple examples of sum and calculating the profit. Then we used multiple lookup formulas where we applied VLOOKUP, index and match, and XLOOKUP with is. Then we performed some product formulation with rounding off to nearest 10, and we used the counting functions with multiple conditionings and got the answers in a very easy way. We had to just copy and paste the formulas from ChatGPT answers and paste in our workbook. So this is how it can facilitate you in getting your work done very quickly. Well, that said, if you've liked the content, then make sure that you hit the like button, subscribe and share. Your comment acts as a navigation tool, so make sure that you give your comments down below in the comment section. Thanks for joining me. See you soon. Take care and bye-bye.